Hello everyone, this is the 10th video of Dynamic Programming Algorithms video series. In this video, I will introduce the policy iteration algorithm and show how to code it in Python. Policy iteration is a way to find the optimal policy for a Markov decision process MDP problem. In the previous video of this video series, I talk about MDP and show how to solve it by using the value iteration algorithm. Since I will use some notation and material from the previous video, I recommend you watch it by clicking the link above if you are not familiar with MDP or value iteration. As a reminder, an MDP can be defined by set of states S, set of actions A, a transition function P, and lastly a reward function R. P S prime given S and A is the probability of moving a state S to another state S prime when action A is taken. And RSA is the reward for taking action A in state S. Our objective in this problem is to find the optimal policy that maximizes total reward where policy assigns an action to each state. To find the optimal policy, we will use the policy iteration algorithm. In the policy iteration algorithm, starting with the initial policy, we will find the optimal policy by iteratively updating it until it converges. On the other hand, in the value iteration algorithm, starting with initial value functions, we find the optimal value functions by iteratively updating them until they converge. This is the main difference between these two algorithms. The policy iteration is an iterative algorithm and consists of three steps. In the first step, we initialize a policy pi 0 with some feasible actions. Then at any iteration I, pi I denotes some policy with pi I s being the action in state s under policy pi I. Then we define v pi I s as the expected reward or the value function in state s under policy pi I. We can calculate v pi I s by taking action pi I s as you see for each state s. On the right hand side, the first part of the summation is the intermediate reward and the second part is the expected future reward. Note that v pi I appears in both sides of the equation. Here, we have a cardinality of set S different linear equations to solve so that we can calculate the value functions under policy pi I. This is the second step and it's called policy evaluation as we evaluate the current policy pi I. In the last step, we improve our current policy by using v pi I. Basically, pi I plus 1 S is equal to argmax of this expression. Again, the first part of the summation is the intermediate reward and the second part is the expected future reward. Until pi I is equal to pi I plus 1, we iterate step 2 and 3. So we can summarize the policy iteration algorithm as you see. In step 1, we choose a policy pi 0 and set I to 0. Then at any iteration I, we calculate the value functions v pi I s for each state s under policy pi I by solving some set of linear equations. This is the policy evaluation step. After calculating these value functions, we compute pi I plus 1 s for each state s by using v pi I s. And this is the policy improvement step. We repeat these two steps until policy pi converges. Now, let's code this algorithm in Python by writing a function called policy iteration. The input of this function is the set of states S as a list, the set of actions A as a list, the transition function P as a function, and lastly, the reward function R as a function. These inputs are totally problem specific. I will later define them for a specific example. In the algorithm, we first initialize policy dictionary by setting its value to some arbitrary feasible action for each state S. Here, I choose to set them to the first element of action set A. Then we have a while loop with a certain true condition. We will terminate it by using break once our termination condition, convergence of the policy, is satisfied. Since we will update the policy at each iteration, I define a variable called oldPolicy to store the policy at the previous iteration. We can initialize it as a copy of the variable policy. As a termination condition, we check whether the policy remains the same by comparing the variable oldPolicy with the variable policy. To update the policy at an iteration, we first calculate the value functions under the current policy. Here I use a function called policyEvaluation. This function takes the current policy along with the set of states S as inputs and then returns the value function under this policy as an output. It is the policy evaluation step of the algorithm. I will show how we can write this function in a bit. After calculating the value functions, we update our current policy by using a function called policy improvement. Different than the function policy evaluation, it takes the value functions together with the set of states S and the set of actions A as inputs and returns the updated policy as an output. This is the policy improvement step of the algorithm. If it's the same with the one in the previous iteration, we break the loop. Finally, we return policy as an output. To complete the implementation of the policy iteration algorithm, now I will show how we can define policy evaluation and policy improvement functions. In policy evaluation function, the idea is updating the value functions under a given policy until they converge. For that, we first initialize the value functions as a dictionary called V. Then we have a while loop with a certain true condition. In this loop, we first create a copy of variable V called OldV. We use the variable OldV while checking the convergence. Then we update the variable V for each state S as you see. This is the expression I showed you earlier by talking about the policy evaluation step. Lastly, we return variable V as an output. On the other hand, in policy improvement function, we will find the best policy for given value functions. We first initialize a dictionary called policy. Then, for each state S, we update the variable policy. Basically, we find the argmax of the expression called Q over action A. This is the expression I showed you earlier while talking about the policy improvement step. Lastly, we return the variable policy as an output. Now we are ready to use policy iteration function with an example. I will use the same example with the previous video, a gambler's problem. So I just copied the variables S, A, P, and R from the previous video. To learn more about this gambler's problem and how we define these variables, please click the link above. To compare the results with the value iteration algorithm in the previous video, I set N to 10 and probability P to 0.4. Now, we are ready to run our policy iteration function for this problem. The output optimal policy looks like as you see. You can see how much the gambler needs to bet in each state by looking at this output. For example, the gambler needs to bet 5 when the current fortune is 5 and 3 when the current fortune is 7. We obtain the same policy as we did by using the value iteration algorithm in the previous video. In this video, I talk about how to implement policy iteration algorithm. I hope that it was helpful. If you have any question about the algorithm or its implementation, please leave a comment.